Fred and Mary, an unconventional romance by award-winning playwright Mickey Shelton, transports Arizonans back in time to our state's pioneering past, where audiences encounter some of the historic figures who made Arizona what it is today. A shared romance for the American Southwest. Do they meet in Mary's mind, in dreams, in an imaginary world? Mary Colter designed the buildings at the Grand Canyon early in the 20th century, in the days when not many female architects existed. The play is based on the lives of Mary Jane Colter and hotelier, restaurateur, Fred Harvey. Fred, along with his prim waitresses, dubbed the Harvey Girls, has been credited with civilizing the West. Together, their reverence for and promotion of Indian art and culture laid the groundwork for what the Southwest is today. Mary Colter, if only by her buildings, it is obvious there's a unique person and creative vision behind them. This play brings Colter alive, her personality, her vision, and her struggles.
I want visitors to experience what it was like to live in a native dwelling. We'll hang pots and baskets from the ceiling, maybe the walls, and feathers here and there, cacti and pots.
Yeah, where visitors watch them carry out their daily lives.
Carding wool, weaving blankets, cooking meals.
Perfect. We'll have Hopi and Navajo artists working right in the shops. Travelers will be able to watch the Apama potters painting designs on their bowls and silversmiths hammering out jewelry. Navajo women at their looms.
That may have worked at the Chicago expedition, but that was for a limited time.
Well, yeah, who's to say we can get the Indians to even go along with it?
You've seen them already lining the tracks, selling everything from food to pottery at the windows of the trains.
In this case, they would have to leave their homes, including Albuquerque, maybe for extended periods of time.
John Ford, you both keep saying that you want to lure people to the Southwest. You don't know if it would be hard to attract the artisans until you try.
What is she doing? She likes kibas.
Playwright Mickey Shelton and director Ellen Bailey worked their magic with strong talents and a great cast in Fred and Mary. The curtains of time were parted, and the audience was swept into the lives of historic Fred Harvey and Mary Elizabeth Jane Colter, and their friends and contemporaries.
Service is slovenly and often insolent. If knives are provided, they're dull as bricklayers' trowels. Even the gravy is too tough for the knives. Passengers complain that they pay for meals en route, only to find that their meals are not ready before the train pulls out. They leave the station as hungry as they arrive. Fine though your trains are, your meals along the route are no better than those along the old Santa Fe Trail. Hardly a standard to be duplicated.
Your point, Mr. Harvey.
Yes, your point. I'm here to make a proposal. I ask your permission to establish eateries all along the new Santa Fe line. And yesterday, well, brawls between the staff and the customers are extremely
unpleasant.
Extremely unpleasant.
Delightful entertainment and a must see. Maria Lamont, a Winslow Harvey girl.
Oh, yes, but you would design things whether the company built them or not. You're quite driven, you know.
And you're not driven, Fred Harvey?
Oh, but everything you do is so perfect.
Oh, you're at least the perfectionist I am. I've heard stories.
Well, I could have gone a bit easier on people. Wanted to do things better than anyone else, I suppose.